Alright, everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Black Closet. Oh my god, that last part was way too long. I'm so sorry. I just get so caught up in this game. Doesn't seem to notice you following, but you don't learn anything new. So this should be fine. Excellent. There you go, it was coming to her, that's all. Yeah, somebody forwarded something naughty, but I deleted it. Okay. Seems that they have. Alright. So another failure. That's great. I am full of failure. There is nothing I can do for that. So we'll go ahead and harass. Guess we'll have to use both of them. Fine, Arena and I had a stupid fight. She started it, and I taught her a lesson. And if she comes near me again, I'll do it again. This is worrying. I mean, now persuade, detain, suspend. Okay. What is going on? Yeah, stupid. Serious invitation said to go alone, but. So. Let's see, what? Your confidence has admitted to having a fight with. Okay. So, given that she was like the main person to fight, I'm gonna go ahead and. Guess I'll have to wait. Okay, we will try with her and just persuade. Assign. And then with her, stake out. And then, well, question. So let's see. That's really not very good. No. Guess we can always harass. The odds are so unknown there. I don't like it. Also inspect, but that's guaranteed for us to lose. So you know what? We're just gonna go to the supply closet. We are banished to the supply closet. Success. Yeah, maybe I'm willing to apologize, but only if she is too. You hide yourself and watch quietly, but no one arrives. After a while, you search the area, but the only clue you find is another black card stapled against the bark of a tree. What's going on? Riding crop. Okay. On the weekend, your minions have a chance to relax and unwind. Stress is reduced by 10. Among the many gifts received as part of the Harvest Tribute, you get a pair of free tickets to Traveling Carnival. This is the last weekend they'll be in town. As it's only appropriate to share them with your fellow queen, you find yourself standing at Teresa's door. Oh, Elsa, what do you want? Carnival tickets. Interested? What? Oh, the festival. Those carnival tickets. I saw them in the tribute listing. I never forget what belongs to me. Us belongs to us. So, if you'd like, I suppose we should go. Where the booths of the school harvest festival tended to. The sedate and sophisticated. The Little Candy Land Carnival is a melange of flashing lights and hawking vendors. Thuds and shrieks of laughter advertise the nearby bumper cars while the Ferris wheel turns slowly overhead. Teresa's at your side, cranes her neck to take in the noise and bustle of the carnival. Very lively. Very crowded. People have that effect. It's a different atmosphere. Contrasts are necessary to enhance the appreciation of elements. Like, I don't know that word. And here we don't have to worry about traitors or saboteurs among the patrons. That's right, isn't it? The school is safe now. Not until we trace the link. Right, right, work. Well, that's your job. You'll figure it out. We're at the fair, right? Let's have some fun. She marches off towards the Ferris wheel, forcing you to hurry to keep up. You wait for your turn in line for the ride, then take your seats and wait for the metal bar to lower and secure you in place. A few minutes later, you are lifted into the air. Looks out over the view below with apparent satisfaction. All those people looked like little dolls from here. You could sweep them aside with one hand. You called me a doll when I was little, Elsa. Do you remember? Your parents dressed you like one. I wanted them to. Then. I won my first beauty contest before I could walk. I was the most beautiful baby. My mother mailed in my photograph on a whim. I still have it framed in my bedroom. When I was old enough to understand what a pageant was, I wanted to compete again. Prize money meant nothing to us, of course. It was the clothes and the attention I wanted. My sister said that when she and her friends, like you, were at the house, I would keep coming into the room in different dresses and parade around. Then Althea would make everyone applaud for me. I don't remember at all. I don't remember all of it, but it sounds like something I would do. But when I started school, that all stopped. You didn't have time for pageants anymore? You're allowed to take a certain amount of time away from school for competition with a national aspect. Nikki used to for skating. So I would have been limited to only a few pageants if my parents hadn't thought my education more important. But that wasn't the part that mattered. It was the show. It was how people treated me. Grown-ups loved me. Strangers would stop in stores and tell my parents what a beautiful child I was, but the kids at school my own age, they're sheep, all of them. They run back and forth in a group, and they never think about anything. They hated me for being pretty until Althea said I was hers and no one was allowed to touch me. Then they were jealous of me for having such a wonderful sister. And then a few years later, everyone wanted to talk about clothes and makeup again after they made fun of me for that in kindergarten. All of a sudden, they wanted to be my friends so that I could make them prettier. Didn't you want to be? Ride's almost over. Don't miss it. See, I did. Neither of those options were good. I hated those options. Once you disembark from the Ferris wheel, Teresa immediately sets off in search of another attraction. She insists that you absolutely must try the chocolate-dipped Belgian waffles and then weaves through all the souvenir stalls to issue stinging indictments of their quality. After that, a round of spinning teacups. Finally, she pauses in her rush from one place to another and looks back at you. Was there anything that you wanted to see? Let's go to the fortune teller. You don't believe in that stuff, do you? It's nice to be flattered. Well, yes, but they'll probably tell everyone else the same story about being rich and beautiful and destined for greatness, whereas for us, it's actually true. She sighs dramatically. If it's what you want, let's go. But I'm picking what we do next. You spend the rest of the day at the carnival together. Well past curfew on Sunday night, you hear something tapping at your window. A scrap of paper is taped to the glass, fluttering in the chill night breeze. Opportunity knocks, old forest, come now or be left behind. And beneath it, a black card with that telltale carmine streak. You can just glimpse the dark outline of the figure sneaking across the grounds towards the forest. There's no time to rouse your minions. If you don't follow now, whoever that is will get away. Let's go! If I die, I die. We'll start up again. Maybe on an easier level, just so that way we don't have to take so much time to get to this point. You slip on your shoes and follow the figure into the dark. Your shoes have fallen leaves, not with a crunch, but with a squelch, rain rising from its grave to drag you under. Your white clothing shines like a signal flare in the moonlight. Your summoner should have no difficulty spotting your approach. Oh, God, look at that face! Well, that is not natural. Oh, it's a mask. Okay, good. Elsa Jackson, You have been tapped. Tapped for what? Membership. We wish you to join our ranks. The Red Mask Society is a sisterhood made up of those who are clever and powerful. We position ourselves so that we may help one another. We can ease your matriculation to the university of your choice and ensure the advancement of your career. We can be of great use to you if you are of use to us. What does he call it? Yeah. An intelligent and ruthless high school student with the potential for greatness. You have passed the first test. If you complete your induction, you will have access to far more than a handful of student minions. Our members are placed in corporations and governments around the world, but their identities and my own must remain secret until you've earned your rank. What do you want me to do? A simple task, well within the powers of student council president. She tosses a thick envelope on the ground between you. This is your assignment. Complete it and you will be rewarded. Fail and you will be punished. With those words, she vanishes into the night. I'm not agreeing to anything, bitch. I guess I did. That wasn't what I was... I was asking what are the requirements for, you know, becoming part of this society, and then I would gauge from there whether I want... So now I have no choice. That's just... All right. Again. All right, soon... In her class is due to unveil her newest work special presentation for the Board of Trustees on November 17th. Make sure the painting she has designed is appropriate. And again from the auditorium. You know, it's probably looking at her cell phone and giggling to herself. Demands that Lynn be convinced to drop out of St. Claudine's. It should look like it was her own idea and not your doing. Begin by separating her from her friends, Freya, Cecilia, and Haley. Maybe. So I believe I persuaded her, so now it's her that needs persuading. Okay, and then what did we make? Looking at her phone and giggling. So we need to question Bobby. And we're gonna stalk her. And then we'll guard. Okay, success. Yeah, maybe I'm willing to apologize, but... says, oh, have you seen that too? It's pretty funny. Whenever I message the girl, definitely knows about it. You may now search Bobby's room. Didn't seem to notice. She didn't learn anything new. That's great. Oh, shit. Okay. We're gonna shake hands and call a truce. So now we can search Bobby's room. See if we can't get that all sorted out. And then we'll question her. Then if we were gonna search that together so that does not do me any good. Question. Then leave that alone. Quietly search her room. Look at Bobby's cell phone and go through it. Her inbox is looking at messages. Everyone's been forwarding. It's a list of student bra sizes. This will cause a scandal if it leaks. You delete it from her phone. Bobby has been neutralized. She is no longer a target in this case. I don't understand why you're asking. Why would I be unhappy here? It says it It's really supposed to be a surprise. Alright. So, we're gonna search her room. Okay, so no matter what, it's not like it's... So... Is this the one where... Yeah, Bobby is no longer... Question and question, and then okay, and then we don't know for that one. We can try questioning. Actually, let's not. Let's send her to the supply closet. Okay. Excellent. The cake worth its opinion of a multi-layered cake. The board can't object to that. Check that. It's okay. Yes, I may forward something like that, but I deleted it. Okay, so they both say... God, I really don't need... absent distress. Alright, so these four are now saying that they don't. Guess all we can do is harass them now. I don't have the email anymore. I forwarded it to Eileen and then I deleted it. Look, I'll show you. Check, my phone is clean now. Has been neutralized. Well, great. Absent distress. Okay, so search. With? No? Okay. Might as well add that for good measure to make sure everything is correct. And then stake out. Oops, I didn't mean to incorporate Rowan in that. Oh well. Stay away from him. Okay. Too close to call. But it's like up to begin kissing. This is not a safe place for such things to carry on. Okay. Hey, when you come out of your room for lunch on Saturday, you find Teresa standing in the hall nearby. Ah? Oh, hello. Were you looking for me? No, I just happened to be here. I'll be going. Wait, have you ever heard of the Red Mask Society? The what? Secret Society. Is it a club here, or are we supposed to be investigating them? I've never heard of any group called the Red Mask. Are they important? Let's confide in her. Hey, what mean? So why are you asking me? It's your business what you do. Whatever, I'm going to lunch. Ta! Reported hearing scratching noises while trying to look wonderful. Name belonging to Petra. Petra remembers seeing. That's lovely. Okay. So, thankfully... we can persuade these two to finish up that case. Now, of the next people. Oh, right. So we can harass these now. And then this one, scratching noises while trying to sleep. Is there some sort of... So, we will go into her room and inspect. Hope for the best. So, okay, so good. I didn't want anyone to see us. I'm sorry, I guess we shouldn't be in there anymore. Should stop the mysterious noises. Excellent. Alright, alright, I'll stay away from Lynn. Awesome. And that's why there's faint scratch marks on the wall, but next to Princess's bed, not Karen's. So, let's question her. Okay, and then we will harass. And then, let's go ahead and inspect Petra's room. And then, we'll go ahead and inspect... Oh, maybe not. Alright, then let's go ahead and question Petra. When she hears the noises, Karen squeaks, clutches her pillow. It's so cute. Alright, alright, I'll stay away from Lynn. Wonderful. Didn't find anything. I remember June asking me about my ring. Okay. Miss Malone, she may be vulnerable, however direct persuasion would be too obvious. You may now mislead Lynn. Absent due to stress. Okay. So, Lynn... mislead. Okay, so that one would be good. And then... pretty sure. Well, can I harass her well? Yes, I can. Okay, and then cafeteria inspect. That's why they've all abandoned me. They hate me. Everyone hates me. Has been neutralized. Is no longer a threat. Okay, I admit it. I was scratching the walls to make Karen squeal. It was just a joke. There we go. Don't find anything. And it's requesting that they let her go home. And then those who are absent due to stress. So, then we are going to question her. And you are going to go to the supply closet. Petra's ring? Yeah, it was really nice, wasn't it? Okay, so now we can search her room. Hall pass. And obedience is rewarded. Improved resources are now available in the supply closet. Yay! Okay. So, one thing is, let's see, so she has the highest, okay, so we're gonna, like, really level up Rowan, then we will search Karen's room, she will go to the supply closet, and then okay, so we want her observation to come up, and I'm just going to use a bunch on her. It just is what it is. Quietly search James' room. Ah, too close to call. Find the ring. Yes. How to get here. So now we'll give her detention. Yay! I got two items now. But you can only bring back one. Let's go ahead and take the social one. Okay. So Holly, oh no, Enchanting Watch is also missing. Oh, damn it. Sharon and Sandy have class recently suspicious injuries. Students have been showing up in class dizzy and disoriented, and behaving inappropriately and falling asleep at their desks. Suspect drug and alcohol. Okay. First, we need to finish up this one. Wait. Search Jan's room. Joy reported Enchanting Watch has gone missing. Okay. So then we need to talk with her. And then for the internet. Why is it doing that? Wow. That's still not even... Like, I can put everyone on there. And it's just... It's not gonna work. So, until... We have... Actually, wait. We can go... With June. Since we found that in hers, we can go detention. Okay. And then, with her... We question... And then, let's see, inappropriately infest students Hayden, Rhonda, and Christy. So, might as well go into Hayden's room. And I mean, we stand a pretty good chance. So, let's go ahead and do that. Too close to call. I don't know what happened to my watch. It's just gone. Cracks and impressions, first and never steal again, counts against your karma. No, nothing wrong. Why do you ask? Quietly enter her room. But we don't find any clues because it's too close to call. Okay. Well, at least we're down. So go ahead and go there. And then we went into Hayden's room, so now we can go into Christy's room. And then we can question these girls. And we're going to try to... No, that's not what I wanted. I wanted to include that perfume since she doesn't have that strong... And wow, look at the reputation and karma. We are not doing well. Okay. So, social. Okay, success. Nothing wrong. That's bullshit. You and I both know that's bullshit. Quietly. Success. Okay, what a score. You find a large box of cardboard stuffed with packets of pills and some in maintenance to have it quietly removed and destroyed. You mean that? Awesome. Okay, so we have Christy. Oh no, I would never drink. And then we have Christy. This is a good school. There are no drugs here. Liar. Arrived at my office. Hi, Elsa. Why do they keep doing this to me? What's wrong? My sister's stupid fan club. Do I look like I'm Althea's relationship agent or something? Marissa, who's a junior, comes up to me with this big box wrapped in white and silver paper and says it's a present, but not a present for me. It's a present for Althea. She wants me to deliver it to my sister for her because she's shy. So I threw it out the window. I can't believe anyone is that stupid. In 7th grade, I posted Megan's love letter to Althea up for the whole class to laugh at, and she was my best friend at the time. What do they expect is going to happen going after me? It's not like Althea needs my approval before she picks up yet another girlfriend. They know Althea cares about you more than... Do you want her to ask for your approval? Cares about you more than them. I wouldn't give it to her. If she asked, it would be too weird. I don't like thinking about her and those girls doing things. Anyway, she shouldn't. She would never take orders from me. I'm little. So, you know, I just thought I would warn you in case Marissa complains. I didn't do anything wrong. She had it coming. Ah, would you like to share tea again sometime? The other freshmen don't appreciate a sophisticated table. That would be nice. Right. Well, ta. She slips out of the room. Okay, wonderful. Now, I've learned. I must be... Ugh, this thing is so... picky. But anyway, we will save...